nice. Listen to how slow can a lister idle. Isn't that amazing? I put a better spring inside there, and it's now tuned correctly. Listen how slow it idles. Take it more slow. That's amazing. Never idle like that. Yes, let me show you some fixes for the day so far. This is the old spring that I put inside. This was too strong, so I find another one, the same length, but it's about half the thickness of this one. And what now happened when I started, you can see it's totally retracted. That little knob there. So when the engine now idles very slow, it come out on idling. Previously it must take off a little bit of rest before it come out. Now on slow idle it come out, and it take the full travel up to this, and then it idled nice. And that is exactly how it should work on very low idle. So when you give them the revs and you pull something and there's any load, it will come back. And I will show you now, I'm going to start it. You will see it on very slow idle. You take the full space up there. And when I shut it down, I'll show you it retract fully. That is exactly how it should work. Everything is set perfectly. Just need the fan belt. But I've done also is this thing. Previously I put a spring in. There's a hole there. And I put a spring in to put a friction on the jet, but that spring was jammed itself. So I put a ball bearing on top of the spring, and now there's a little bit of a knurling here. So now you can hear. Okay, you don't hear it, but I can feel it. Click, 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 click. You understand? So that ball bearing run on that knurling. It's not actually a knurling, it is little steps like that. So it sit there very nice. So that is now fixed. I cut this handle shorter, so it looks much better now. And finish it up a little bit there. And put just a little bit of green paint. It's not the correct paint or the original or the next final layer. It's just to let it looks better for the moment and prevent rust. And okay, and I've also put brand new fuel pipe in. That was a thicker piece, and that is also a new brand new fuel pipe. So that looks already better. And look how convenient is that. It's not fully open, but this fuel can of mine that I made myself just work perfectly. And I use it a lot in the meantime. So I drained the fuel for replacing the pipes. Start removing all dirt and crime. Okay, let me continue. I'll bring you back. Okay, how's does that look? You see, the idea is to get it like that all over before pressure wash. So this is only one part I do quickly. Okay, there's your before and the after, gentlemen. That looks nice. That comes very nice. I must tell you, I don't want or I don't worry to respray this machine or clean and respray it because it was resprayed already. Overall, I found blue paint all over the place. So it was blue at a point, but my best guess is this machine came standard out green. So I guess it was green and then blue and somebody painted green again, and I've at a point when I get it running, I paint it again green. So I don't mind to do it over because it's not its original clothes. Same with the thermal. It was already painted previously, but it comes nice. Okay, gents, I think we must do a startup for today for a video. And listen to that nice idle, and then we'll take it from there. Yeah, I mentioned the new fuel pipe and so on. Okay, and I also repaired my crank. Beautiful. See you on the next one. Tomorrow we will proceed in the cleaning and repair a couple of stuff. The next video, tomorrow we will remove the fan and clean the bearings up.